What a final we had last year. The one-man show of Shane Gostisbehere, a +7, leads the Union Dutchman to back-to-back titles for the ECAC. Will that conference make it 3 years in a row? Who will be the new champ? The road to the Frozen Four begins right here, right now. What's up? We are men wearing makeup and talking about hockey. College hockey specifically, I'm John Butchergrass, and what ASAP Ferg is to the ASAP mob, Dave Starman is to college hockey. Good to see you, my man. You were in Minneapolis late last night, right?
Great tournament, big upset. It was a lot of fun. St. Cloud State got their way in.
Going to be a great show. Of course, we're here to unveil the 16 teams that will make the NCAA tournament, but also just here to talk hockey. That's always a good thing. Our viewers don't get enough of that in America, so we're glad to be here. All right, the field. How does the process work? The NCAA hockey tournament comprised of 16 teams, four regions. You know that. The winner goes to the Frozen Four in Boston, Massachusetts. They'll play at the Garden this year. Six of the bids for a conference tourney champions, 10 at large, determined by pairwise. Top four teams are awarded number one seeds, with preference given to regional location. Let's head out west now to Fargo and see what's going on out there. There, of course, the one seed, North Dakota, and they go up against in their first round game on ESPNU Friday at 8 o'clock. Sam Annis, incredible set of mitts. Goal scorer may not be able to go because of his lower body injury.
Which means Mike Gartey, their goaltender, a little bit more pressure on him to hold the fort. Quinnipiac got a slow start, but they really stabilized things. Matt Pekka, who's been a veteran, he's been around a while. You've called his name a lot.
Yep.
He's been a guy that has helped make this team a little bit more consistent. And Landon Smith has been a player.
Right, John Butchergrass, Dave Starman with you here as the 2015 NCAA Hockey Selection Show presented by Northwestern Mutual. These are the opening road games again. This is where you can see the network and the time on Friday, Yale BU on ESPNU, St. Cloud, Michigan Tech, ESPN3. And then on Saturday as well, BC Denver, Providence and Miami, Harvard Omaha. So there it is. TiVo that, take a picture of it, freeze it with your phone, then you got it. Network and time. Well, once again, one more question, Coach. You play Quinnipiac, very well coached. Rand Pecknall and his staff recruit well. They coach well. Matthew Peck is one of the best players in the country. Sam Annis might not be able to go, maybe the power play. What do you know about Quinnipiac?
Well, start with exactly what you said. This is a team, veteran group that, you know, has been through this time of year and has experience at this time of year. Rand does an outstanding job with his group. The players that you mentioned are some of the best in the country. But, you know, again, I look at a team that plays with depth through their lineup and plays the game the right way. They're a real tough matchup and a tough opponent. They're one group that we're going to have to prepare very, very well for. It should make for a great matchup.
On ESPNU, Friday, 8 o'clock Eastern time. Coach, good luck.
Thank you, gentlemen.
We're excited about it. You know, North Dakota is one of the best teams in the country over the last 20, 30, maybe even 40 years. As of today, they're the number one team in the country. And we're looking forward. I think it's a unique opportunity to have to not only play North Dakota, but have to play them in North Dakota. Dave Haxtell is a great coach, runs a great program, one of the better coaches in college hockey. So, we're excited on the draw and looking forward to playing the NCAA tournament.
It's exciting. It's definitely a pretty huge accomplishment. Obviously, it's pretty difficult to make the tournament. We're pretty happy. We feel pretty fortunate that we got in again. Obviously, it was a disappointing end to our season in Lake Placid. So, you know, we're pretty hungry. The vibe around the dressing room is pretty good because, you know, we got a second chance, and we're pretty excited to get going.
What do you think, little buddy?